This is our VM200 rear snack drop vendor. First, locate your keys. Insert the key. Turn counterclockwise several times until open. Two foam blocks holding the tray. These are for shipping purposes only. Pull the snack tray forward. Looking down into the snack tray, you'll notice 9 coils as well as 8 slide racks. The 9 coils are to accommodate different size products. When loading the machine, be sure to place the product in between the coil, not on top of the coil. When loading, be sure to load from the front loop through to the back. After all the product has vented from the machine, to retrieve the money, put your keys in the left and right side of the coin box. Turn counterclockwise, lift and pull off the coin box. In the event of a jammed coin mech, one way to unjam it is to take your 2 blockout pins and position them inside the top of the coin mech like you're setting the price to 0. Once the pins are in the correct position, totaling 4, you can then turn the coin mech until it pops open. Another way to unjam a coin mech is to remove the coin mechanism. First, you would remove the coil by pushing the bottom loop over and pulling it up. Then, you will remove the 2 screws, one on the top and one on the bottom. To unjam the coin mech with the 4 pins still on the top, remove the screw on the back end of the coin mech. Turn the front knob clockwise. Open. Once you've freed the barrel of the coin mech, to replace the ratchet, make sure the arrow is pointing straight up to meet the arrow pointing straight down. Place the ratchet in position with the slot facing straight down. Position the plate. Hold firmly and insert the screw. With the pins still on the top, reposition the coin mech back into the slot. Refasten the 2 screws on the top and bottom. Turn the knob so the slot on the back of the coin mechanism is facing upward. Take the crossbar of the coil, put it through the slot and down through the hole. Then complete the turn of the coin mechanism. This is our VM250 cold drink vendor. First, locate your keys inside the front door. Insert your key and turn counterclockwise several times until open. To set prices and retrieve the money, you have to place the 2 keys in the left and right side of the change box. Turn the 2 keys counterclockwise and pull off the change box. To retrieve the money, just turn over the coin box if you're changing prices, leave the box off to view the pins in the top of the coin mix. When loading the unit, place the can sideways down the chute. Remember to leave the last couple of cans on the top of the chute. Note, do not turn the coin mech or lift the lever when there's nothing inside of the chute. This will cause the coin mech to jam. This machine has a sold-out feature. Once the last can has vended, the machine will keep the change inside the coin mech, preventing another customer to put more money without retrieving a can. When the machine is in its sold-out position, the only thing you need to do is reload the chute and turn the coin mech. This unit can be combined with our snack vendor and our coin changer. This machine has four holes for the mounting of our snack vendor, as well as four pre-drilled holes on the side for the mounting of our coin changer. When mounting either our snack or coin changer, be sure to use the small screws provided with each machine. In the event of a jammed coin mech, one way to unjam is to place all four pins in the top of the coin mech, like you're setting the price to zero. Once the pins are inserted correctly, just turn the coin mechanism until it pops back open. Another way to unjam a coin mech is by removing the nut on the side of the rod. Remove the rod from the lever and let the rod just hang in the machine. Lift the lever to remove any cans left in the column. Once the cans are removed from the column, follow the rod up into the machine with your hand. You should feel the L-shaped arm. With the pins in the top of the coin mech, turn the arm clockwise until the knob pops out and the arm is pointing straight down to a 6 o'clock position. It is very important that the L arm is straight down to a 6 o'clock position. Once the coin mech is open and the arm in the back is straight down to a 6 o'clock position, to adjust the rod to the lever, make sure the lever is down. You should only have to lift the lever about 1/8 of an inch to reattach the rod. If you have to lift the lever more than 1/8 of an inch, you should turn the rod counterclockwise to bring it down, or clockwise to bring it up. Place the rod back on the lever and fasten the nut. To remove the coin mech, turn the rod counterclockwise. Take the rod out of the machine. Place coins in the coin mech, whatever price you have it set for, and turn it to a 3 o'clock position. Remove the four screws, two on the bottom and two on the top. Then remove the coin mech. When installing a new coin mech, place the money in the knob for whatever price it's set. Turn the knob to a 3 o'clock position. Remove the screws in the top and bottom of the coin mech. Place it into the machine. Put the 4 screws back into the coin mech. Reattach the rod into the L arm inside the back of the coin mech. Finish the turn on the coin mech. Then place the rod onto the lever, fasten the nut. Remember to position 1 can for each product at the top of the coin mech for proper display. Our VM250 cold drink vendor has a refrigeration modular unit. Only in the event of a refrigeration problem, after being instructed by our tech support, you will remove the screws on the back panel of the machine. Remove the nuts on the right and left sides of the tray. You will pull out the modular unit, and if instructed to, you will send just this module and follow any instructions given by our technical support. This is our VM010 dollar bill changer. First, locate your keys. Insert your key and turn it counterclockwise to open the door. Pull forward the tubes and holster. Try to identify with the different parts of the unit. On the door is the bill validator. On the side of the bill validator is the little white dip switches, which tell the machine how much coins to vend. On the top, notice the different tubes, 2 dime tubes, 2 quarter tubes, followed by another quarter tube with a nickel tube insert and another quarter tube. On the side of the quarter / nickel tube, you'll see the sensor, which is this black housing and the silver pendulum. On the back of the housing is this metal square box, which holds the circuit board. Under the box, we have the solenoid and the transformer. The fuse on this unit may be positioned in 1 out of 2 places. 1, it can be positioned on the inside of the unit, on the back wall, or in the back of the unit. When mounting the change machine, you may need 2 people, 1 person to hold up the unit while you put the tubes and holster on the side. Remove the black plugs while the second person holds the machine. You're going to take the screw and place it from the inside through the outside. Our coin changer can dispense either 2 dimes, 3 quarters, and a nickel, or remove the metal brace on the side of the nickel tube
Yeah.
Pull out the nickel tube. Leave the two dime slots empty.
Nothing about vending machines.
And fill just the four front existing quarter tubes to dispense four quarters. If the lights are flashing and it will not take a dollar bill, usually the lights mean that it's out of change. Open the door, pull for the tubes. If the tubes are filled and the nickel slash quarter tube is filled past the silver pendulum and the lights are still flashing, put something in the way of the silver pendulum and the nickel tube to hold the pendulum all the way back into the black housing. Take a look at the lights on the front door and see if they're still flashing. If the lights stop flashing, then all you will need to do is put your thumb against the black housing and push it in closer to the nickel tube. If the sensor is not pushed in close enough to the tubes where the pendulum isn't all the way back in the black housing, it will not read that there's coins in the unit. After having pushed the black housing closer to the tube and the lights are still flashing, please call tech support for further instructions. In the event that there is no power at all to the unit, first, check your fuse. If the fuse is good and there's still no power to the unit, pull out the tubes, the square box on the back of the unit that covers the circuit board. Remove the screw on the lip of the box and lift it off the circuit board. Check the board to see if there's one illuminated red light. If the light is not illuminated, call tech support. If the unit accepts the dollar bill but does not dispense coins, check the nickel tube insert in the quarter tube. If the brace is not holding the tube suspended in the right position, the tube may fall, preventing the slide plate from distributing the coins. In the event that your validator is not accepting bills and the lights are solid, indicating that there is change in the unit, open the door, remove the four nuts that hold the validator onto the door, unplug the validator from the side, lift it from the door. On the side, you have two finger screws. Loosen the finger screws, then open from the top. With a cotton swab, light alcohol on one side, dry on the other side. Lightly wipe the eyes, the belt, and the reader with the wet end of the swab, and immediately dry with the dryer. After cleaning, close the validator, tighten the finger screws, place the validator back in position, plug in the side, and refasten the nuts. After cleaning your validator, if it still does not accept build, call tech support. This is our coin mechanism of the snack time and drink time vending machines. This coin mechanism will accept $2 or $1.25. $2 using the golden dollar and 4 quarters, or $1.25 using 5 quarters. If using the last slot, which is for either a quarter or a golden dollar, you will have to remove the white blackout tab and insert either the white quarter insert for a quarter or leave empty for a golden dollar. If you're not going to use the last slot for either a fifth quarter or a golden dollar, leave the white blackout tab in the last position. And make sure you also leave the last pin in the very back. To set price for 75 cents, you will remove one of the blackout tabs with your needle nose pliers, as well as one of the blackout pins in the top of the coin mechanism. If you're going to set the coin mechanism for 55 cents, once you remove the blackout tab, you will insert either a nickel insert or a dime insert, depending on what price you want to set. It is important to remember, for every space that you're going to use for a coin, you have to remove the corresponding pin in the top. For every space you're not going to use, you have to add a pin in the top. For instance, the price is now set to 75 cents because there are only 3 blank spaces in the barrel and 3 pins missing from the top. To set this coin mech back to 50 cents, you will reinsert one of the blackout tabs, as well as one of the pins in the top. This leaves 2 slots open and 2 pins missing. To disassemble a coin mechanism, you will first remove the 4 screws in the top and bottom of the coin mechanism. Then remove the screws on the back of the coin mechanism. Take off the back ratchet and plate. Inside the back of the coin mech on the bottom, you'll see what's called our anti-reverse dog. This prevents the coin mechanism from turning counterclockwise when there is no money placed inside. Remove the screw on the side of the coin mechanism. Under the bottom plate of the coin mech, you'll see a pin. Just tap it to the surface. Remove the faceplate and barrel and the 5 fingers inside, along with the spring that holds the fingers. Each coin mech is made of 5 fingers, finger spring, an anti-reverse dog, the housing, the front plate, the rear plate, a screw pin and the bottom pin, ratchet spring, a barrel, a half ratchet for a snack machine, and a full ratchet for the drink machine. To reassemble the coin mechanism, you'll take the housing, place the finger spring on the housing, followed by the five fingers, take the barrel, put it through the faceplate, and wiggle the barrel past the fingers, putting the faceplate on. Now, place the bottom pin under the faceplate into the bottom of the coin mechanism. Take the side screw pin and put it in to the side of the coin mechanism. Now, fasten the faceplate down to the housing with the four screws. Make sure the barrel is open and pointing straight up. Insert the anti-reverse coil. For the snack machine, insert the half ratchet. For the drink machine, you'll insert the full ratchet. You take your spring, place it inside the hole of the ratchet, place the ratchet into the back of the coin mechanism. Make sure the front is facing up and the slot is facing straight up and down at a 12 o'clock position. With the ratchet in place, fasten the back plate over it. Hopefully, these troubleshooting tips will assist you. If you need any further assistance, please call technical support.